Hello there guys, welcome to another video in which I'll be playing some more War Thunder. And in this video we're going to be taking a look at the Valentine Mk XI. I haven't covered a lot of the British tanks in my videos yet, as the British tanks are fairly new and I haven't been active ever since they have come out. But I am definitely planning on covering a lot of the British tanks. Now, recently I've uploaded a video with the Black Prince in it, and I didn't, like, review it. I just used gameplay of me in the Black Prince. But I'm planning on reviewing that tank in the future as well. But first I want to talk about the Valentine Mk XI. The Valentine Mk XI is a battle rating 3.0 tank on the British tech tree. It is a medium tank that was developed in 1938, and then it was produced between 1940 and 1944. Now this tank saw extensive use in the North African campaign, for example in Egypt and those North African countries over there. Now the Valentine Mk XI holds a 75mm cannon that is very, very powerful. This cannon right here is capable of penetrating up to 109mm of armor at a distance of 100 meters. And at battle rating 3.0, that is very, very much penetration. And I definitely think that this is one of the better cannons at this battle rating. Now, it only shoots AP and APCBC shells, I believe. Let me quickly check that. Yeah, it only shoots AP rounds and APCBC rounds. So it doesn't have APHE, which means that it won't deal an insane amount of damage. But with the reload rate of 6.5 seconds and the ease of penetration that this tank has, you can definitely cause havoc at the enemy team. Now the armor is fairly decent as well. It has got 50 to 65mm of armor pretty much all around the tank, except for on a few spots. Right here it's only got 30mm of armor, but because it is sloped, the effective thickness is about 68mm at an angle of 68 degrees, so they'll have quite a hard time trying to penetrate through that plate over there because it is so insanely sloped. And we have the same thing in the back, but it's only 17mm over there, so they will penetrate that quite easily. Now, the tank is also fairly slow. It only goes 24 per hour, which is very, very slow for a tank, and much slower than I'm used to. Now, this tank only weighs 18 tons, and it's a very small tank, so I'm not sure why this tank goes this slowly. I suppose it's because it's got a rather weak engine. Anyhow, let's take this tank out into battle and let's see what is going to happen. So I'll see you guys in a bit. Okay guys, we are in the frozen map, or the frozen pass map. So let's see what we're going to do. Now this is a very new map, a map that came with update 1.57. And I don't know this map too well. Now I've played it a couple of times, not too often, but I like it very much. I mean, let's just look around for a bit. I mean, this map is absolutely gorgeous. I love it. But what are we going to do? Now, like I've said, the Valentine Mk XI is a very slow tank. It only goes 24 per hour. And flanking with this tank is not really an option, as it is a little bit too slow to do so. So my plan for now is to go into this northern city over here and to try and engage with enemies over there. Now there's M22 Locust over here as well, so hopefully he can do some scouting work. But let's see what is going to happen. Now at the moment I preferably stick to the left side because the enemies so I will stick right here because the enemies will be coming from here, and if I'm in the city itself I'll be easy to spot, and I'll be slightly hard to spot from here. So let's move up and let's try to take out some enemies. Now I am not sure how this is gonna work out because I am quite inexperienced with the British tanks still. I've played them quite a bit the last few days, but I am quite used to faster vehicles, faster and lighter vehicles, such as the M18 Hellcat or the M24 Chevy. But I'm going to try to take out some enemies nonetheless, and let's see how we are going to do. Now, we are reaching our first crossfire point, where enemies might be coming from the left and from our front. Okay, looks like there's someone in the city already. That is not good. I think we might take a left over here. Seems to be a couple of enemies over there. This Crusader is engaging with them as well. Not sure if I want to interfere with that. I think I do for now. Okay, track down. Great. Not very useful at shot. Okay, ground unit destroyed. Perfect, perfect. Good. Okay, now I know for a fact that there's... Ooh, that was a shot that went right past my head. Okay, I know for a fact that there will be more over right there. And it looks... Yeah, we've got a German over here as well. Let's take his track out so he can't fuck us up. There we go. Oh! Left side! There we go, commander down. Okay, he's down. Good. Good shot, mate. Not sure where the rest of the enemies are. I can't quite see them. Oh boy. Oh boy. They somehow managed to get behind me. Yeah, there they are. I'm dead. I'm so dead. Ooh, I'm alive. He messed up. Perfect. Okay, gunner down. That's good. Loader hit. Okay, okay. I have to shoot right here to disable this vehicle, I think. Yeah, there we go. Oh man. That was intense. I'm not sure where he came from, but as soon as I saw him, I thought it was a Panzer F... a Panzer F2, which is the German tank with the... I believe it's also a 75mm cannon. And that thing has absolutely ridiculous penetration value, so he would kill you one shot, guaranteed. But it wasn't, and we're still alive, so let's move up. Now, I am gonna go for objective Bravo. If I manage to get in there, then I can start capping it, which will pretty much force the enemy to fall back. And if they don't fall back, we win the match. Either way, it will deliver our team a good bonus. So let's try and do that. Or let's go ahead and do that, hopefully. Now, I am not entirely sure about how many players are respawning on our team at the moment, and I'm not sure how well our defense is coordinated either, so the match might still go all ways, because it looks like we are losing quite heavily. We have suffered major casualties, and they have barely lost any vehicles at all, which obviously is not good, and we are still losing vehicles at this point, so I am really gonna give it my best in the hopes that we win, because I'm not gonna give up, that's for sure. Keep pushing. Where the hell is Bravo? Is it behind this hill? I think it is. Okay. Now, enemies can come from everywhere, including from the spawn. I'm actually pretty much within their spawn at the moment. That's an enemy airplane. Sounds like a Heinkel. Not sure if it's also a Heinkel. No, it's an SB2M. Close enough. Not. Okay. We reached the cap area, so we might actually start capping the zone right now. I still have no clue where they're gonna come from, so I don't know where I want to position my vehicle either. The Crusader seems to be watching our backs. I'm gonna watch our front. Let's see if this is gonna work out. Well, at least we're capping it, and I'm not seeing any resistance yet, so not entirely sure if they're going to retreat. It really depends on... Oh boy. Oh boy. Okay, that sucks. What's the plan here? What's the... Okay. There is no plan anymore. Genius. They're capturing our zone as well, so I am actually gonna have to interfere with some death from above. Not sure how much time I have. I think I've got enough time to take out the vehicles with the wearaway. Okay, we only have to fight your spawn. That's alright though. Oh fuck, we have a very, very far spawn. Yeah, we're gonna have to hurry up. We are gonna have to hurry up very much. Now, the teams have been equalized a little bit more. They have suffered major casualties as well now, and we still do have a good amount of vehicles on the ground, so this battle is definitely not lost yet. However, I do see three enemy aircraft up there, and all three of them are gonna be bombers. So I am excited to see what's going to happen. I'm gonna take a sip of my beer so I can stay hydrated, sort of. Okay, yeah, that's definitely a bomber up there. Now, we are capturing back zone A, and one of them is capturing zone B, so I might actually take out the vehicle that is capturing their own zone back, so that I can make sure the enemies lose some vehicles, at least. It's not really reinforcements, because the player was already spawned, but... still, same point. Okay, he's right there, right on the side of the cap circle. Engines idle. There we go. Okay, this is gonna be a tough bombing run. Bomb's gone. Pull up. It's gonna be a hit. Might be. Yeah, it's a hit. Not a kill, but at least we hit him. That's a start, at least. Okay. Ooh, he stopped moving. Enemy kill assist. Okay, it's one enemy down. Still an enemy over here though. That's definitely gonna hit. That should be a kill right there. Yeah, it's a kill. That was right next to him. Beautiful. Okay, let's take the role of a fighter. Okay, that bomber is going down by the looks of it. Yeah, he's dead. He is dead for sure. Perfect. I don't see any other enemy airplanes up, so I might actually go for a rearm. What's that? Where did those bombs come from? Oh, okay. Well, there's one up there, but I'm not gonna bother and take him down, because this thing doesn't climb for shit. Okay, and there's another vehicle over there. Oh boy. What the hell is that? What airplane is that? I don't know that plane. If I kill it, I'll probably know it, but I can't quite identify it at the moment. Our engine is definitely overheating at the moment. That's bad. That's very bad. And he's still trying to spray me down with his gunners, ironically. Now, he is at our airfield, so he might die. What is he doing? I think that's an SB2M as well, perhaps? I'm not sure. I don't know. He can't go anywhere. I'm just gonna keep chasing him for now, because he can't do a bomb run if I keep going after him. Now, I did lose him, kinda. Ah, there he is. I think there might be a Russian SB2M bomber. Oh, critical hit! The wearaway is overpowered, please nerf. Say what? Oh boy. Oh boy. Okay, okay, let's let him burn down. Let's just let him burn down. What airplane is that though? Yeah, it's an SB2M, okay. Yeah, he's dead, we got him. Sweet. Okay. That is pretty cool. Damn. Okay, let's start landing, because our engine won't last much longer in this state. Gear out, landing flaps out. Let's go for a landing approach right here. Holy crap. That was such a lucky shot though, that we lit him on fire right there, because This plane has got horrible armament. I mean offensive armaments by that, and excluding the bombs then. I mean it's only got two 7.5 or 7.7mm machine guns, not sure how big they are. I will check for you guys in a bit. Let's first land. Flaps off for more braking power. There we go. Okay, let's take a quick look. What does this thing have? 7.7s. Well, they are still quite shitty, but like you've just seen, they can sometimes be useful, so that's a positive note. Now let's rearm and repair, and then let's go back into the battlefield. It looks like we are capturing Zone B again, and we also have turned around this match because the enemies have suffered major casualties at the moment. The most of them have died at least two times or they are out of the game, and we still have quite some players that only died once. So momentarily we do have the advantage, which is perfect. Now the enemies are capturing Zone B again, so we didn't win yet. We can still very very possibly lose, but I'm just gonna go for another bombing run. Just for the record, I'm carrying two 500 pound and two 250 pound bombs. That's the am I right about that? Yep, I got it right, okay. And that's the equivalent of approximately 675 kilograms of bombs, I suppose. Not too much. This plane isn't the best bomber around, but you know, it does the job. And aside from that, it's a fucking wearaway, man. Who doesn't like the wearaway? I love this plane. I mean, it's not a very good plane, but you just don't see it very often, and it's just a fun thing to fly. It's just so satisfying when you kill an enemy with the two 7.7mm machine guns, and it is actually reasonably good at dive bombing as well, so I like it a lot. I see it as the British version of a Stuka. I think that's actually the perfect description of this airplane, the British version of the Stuka, so yeah. Now I know this video isn't originally about the wearaway, but let's talk about it anyway, because you know, it's an interesting airplane. So the wearaway originally was an Australian aircraft, not sure when it was produced, but during the Second World War, the wearaway was mainly used as a trainer airplane. It wasn't very often used as an offensive airplane, as it was very outdated and not advanced enough as a main role aircraft. But they used it as a trainer a lot as well, and you can see it's got quite a large cockpit, so you could easily fit an instructor in there. And that's quite an interesting fact, I think. Now, I don't know super much about this airplane, I just know that I like flying it, which is the most important thing. But, oh boy. Dodging maneuvers. Oh boy, that's a Yak-9. Okay, we dodged him. We successfully evaded his attacks. Good. Now, where's the tank over here? Ooh. Okay, let's go around, Two tanks over there, we could take both of them out, potentially. Go for a looping. This is gonna be some spicy footwork over here. But it's possible, if the Yak-9 doesn't shoot us down, obviously. Okay. Those bombs are gonna hit, easy hit, right there. Oh, he died already. that's disappointing, the enemy died already. Okay. No problem, though. Oh boy. Son of a bitch. Okay, let's hope we kill his crew. Yeah, he's dead. Oh, he's not dead. Fuck. Okay. Landing flaps out. Let's go for a new engagement with the machine guns. I know we can take him out with machine guns as well, so critical hit. Good. Okay. I'm not sure whether his driver is still alive. Oh. Yep. That ripped straight off. No problem, though. I'm not sure what vehicle I want to take, in all honesty. Yeah, we took out his driver. We didn't take out his gunner. Okay. Let's go with the 3-inch gun carrier, because that's the only vehicle we can momentarily spawn in. And it looks like our team does need some more foot on the ground, so let's go ahead and engage the enemy. Now, there's one person at Objective Bravo already, so he might actually capture it, which would be amazing. But, yeah, let's keep moving for now. We do definitely have air superiority there. We've got 3 aircraft in the sky. All 3 of which are bombers. One of them just got shot down, I think. We did lose 1 aircraft, unfortunately. Or 1 airplane. Got a kill assist, that's the AA going down, perfect. Okay. Now let's move toward Objective Bravo. It might take a while before we get hit, or before we get there, because obviously this is a very, very heavy tank destroyer. How much does it weigh? I wonder. 39 tons. Now that is very heavy, especially for an engine with only 340 horsepower. So, yeah. But let's move up for now. I don't think there's much left of the enemy teams. I'm not sure how interesting the rest of this match is going to be. Now, if not much else is going to happen, then I'll be fast forwarding to the next match right now. Actually, it's been quite a long video already. How long have we been going? Yeah, we've been going for quite a long time already. I don't know. If not much else interesting is going to happen during this match, then I'll fast forward to the ending of this video. And if there is still stuff to happen, then I suppose I will keep talking to you guys right now. So, yeah. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Hopefully you also like War Thunder. Because in that case, consider liking, subscribing, commenting, favoriting, and sharing this video. So yeah, guys. I'm not sure what vehicle I'm going to go for next time. If you have a suggestion, please leave it behind in the comment section below. And then I guess I'll see you guys next time. Have a nice weekend, have a great rest of your day, and thank you for watching.